Hello students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jagdeep. This video series is focused on indifference curve analysis for the advanced segment. In our previous video, we talked about derivation of demand curve for given goods. In this video, we will talk about Slutsky's substitution effect. This video shall focus on its meaning and introduction. So without wasting any time further, let's get started. We've already studied how the Hickson substitution effect works, and we've seen the diagrammatic representation of that as well. So when we talk about Slutsky's substitution effect, it is focused on original standard of living concept. What does that mean? So Slutsky's substitution effect is based on the fact that whenever the price of a commodity changes, the income of the consumer will be reduced or increased, whatever the case is, however the price is moving, will be reduced or increased by an amount that will allow the consumer to purchase his initial combination of goods if he chooses to. That means he's not only keeping the consumer's utility constant, but he is also ensuring that the real income of the consumer is kept constant. All right, and that is done majorly by changing his income. All right, the amount of income that is changed over here is basically referred to as the cost difference. How do we arrive at that? Technically, the cost that a consumer is incurring to buy the commodity at old price minus the cost of the commodity that the consumer will be buying at the new price will give us the cost difference. To make it more understandable, let's take a numerical example. So in this numerical example, we are assuming that the consumer is buying 10 units of commodity X at $5 and a certain quantity of commodity Y. We don't have numericals for quantity Y because we are focusing on just one single commodity here. Now, if we assume that the price of commodity X is falling to $3, then how do we calculate the cost difference? It is 5 times 10, which is the quantity that he was buying at initial price, minus 3 times 10, which is the quantity he will be buying at the new price. So the difference is 2 times 10. That comes out to maybe $20. And this is the amount of money or income that will be reduced in this particular example. All right. So according to this example, as I've written over here, the income of the consumer will be reduced by $20. How would that look like on a diagram is something we will take a look at in the next class. In this video, we shall take a look at how both the substitution effects are different. So let's delve in. So these are some basic differences that you would find when you compare the substitution effect given by Hicks and Slutsky. So according to Hicks, when a consumer attains his new equilibrium after the price effect and income effect and substitution effect has been dealt with, the consumer will remain on the same indifference curve. That means his utility will remain the same. Let me supplement a small example here how Hicks's substitution effect looked like. So let us say this is the initial budget line AB, then we have the IC curve here, equilibrium here, this is the quantity. If the price of commodity X falls, this is how the new budget line would look like. And probably the consumer would go somewhere here. So let us say this is, so let's say this is IC1 and let us say E1. And we don't want the consumer to be here because the real income has increased. So we take away some of his income. There'll be a parallel shift inwards in the budget line. So this new budget line, let us say MN. So this MN is now tangent to the initial IC curve. At this point, let me name it as T. So at point T, the quantity consumed is Q1, right? And the movement from E to T is the Hickson substitution effect. So the consumer would more or less remain on the same IC curve. However, according to Slutsky, we'll take a look at the diagram in the next video. He proposes that the consumer should be able to buy the initial combination, which is E. We'll see when we draw the diagram whether the consumer does buy E or not. Another difference is the method that Hicks uses is called income compensating variation, whereas the method used by Slutsky is called cost difference. Alright, students? Students, if you find my videos useful, please subscribe to my channel and share my videos with your friends. If you find learning through long videos difficult and demotivating, you could also follow me on Instagram and learn through reels in a shorter duration. I shall be releasing the notes as soon as possible, and it shall be released on my Facebook page. So you could go ahead and follow me on my Facebook page as well. All right. I'll see you in the next video with a diagrammatic representation of Slutsky's substitution effect. Until then, bye now. Take care.